my Aunt Max. And this is your cyborg beast.
Hi, I'm Wes. I helped my teacher, Mr. Lair, build the cyborg beast. Mr. Lair is Max's dad. When Max was born, his right hand wasn't fully developed, so it was hard for him to use it. Now, with the cyborg beast, he can grip, which is really useful when he wants to use both hands at the same time. We built the cyborg beast using a 3D printer. This is a 3D printer, and then this is the computer that's sending a computer file to the 3D printer, telling it what to print. And these are spools, which are wrapped around with this plastic that's being melted on this little extruder. What's cool about a 3D printer is you can build a three-dimensional object with a computer file of the object. The machine prints layer by layer by layer using liquid plastic. So here's how the cyborg beast works. When Max bends his wrist down, the fingers come down too, because they're being pulled. And when Max returns his wrist to a straight position, the fingers open up and go back to normal. But here's the problem. The cyborg beast takes a lot of forearm strength to make it move.
It's tough to push down.
So it's hard for a kid Max's age to use it for a long period of time. So we're gonna build a new 3D printed hand for Max so that it's easier to use. It's called the Raptor. A raptor is a kind of bird. The hand designer, Peter Binkley, created it and named it after his son, Peregrine, also a type of bird. This is the Raptor. Fist bump. Boom. I've already done a lot of work on the Raptor. First, I went to the Enable website and downloaded all the individual files. Enable is a group of people from all over the world who use engineering and 3D printing to make fingers and hands. Altogether, the pieces and hardware came up to be about $35. That's cheap! Then, after I printed them all, I had to assemble the Raptor. And that took about 3 hours. With the Raptor, the cords don't have to bend over the top of the hand like they do with the cyborg. This decreases friction and makes it a lot easier to bend the fingers down. The less friction, the easier the motion. Now I'm done to the final exciting part, where we get to put together the finishing touches. I'm cutting off the spongy cord, then I pull, and then once I'm at the right amount of tightness, this is gonna keep the thumb up when he's not bending his wrist. The next step is to put on these finger grips. These add friction to whatever the fingers touch, which is helpful when you're trying to use the fingers to grab something. I can't wait to try this with Max.
Except for me.
What do you think?
Good.
Is it easier to move? Is it comfortable?
Mm-hmm. It's a little uncomfortable.
Where is it uncomfortable?
Right here.
Okay. I may be able to fix that. Max just told me that the Raptor is hurting his hand right here on the top of the gauntlet. So I'm going to put some foam under this Velcro and see if that will help at all.
Did you put foam in?
Uh-huh. Right there. So now it shouldn't hurt your hand like it did last time.
It works.
Nice. I love engineering because I can use it to help people. I'm hoping to start a new club at my school so I can make 3D printed hands with my friends.
Thank you.
No problem. High five?